So this week, Judge Arthur Engoron, the one who has been overseeing the New York fraud trial against Donald Trump, sent a letter to both the prosecutors and Trump's lawyers asking them to respond to a report recently from the New York Times that says that Trump Organization Chief Financial Officer Alan Weisselberg was in talks with Alvin Bragg for a plea deal for potential perjury that occurred during the New York fraud trial. Now, little backstory on what allegedly happened. Weisselberg took the stand for the New York fraud trial, started talking about how, hey, I never told the Wall Street or Forbes, it was, excuse me. I never told Forbes the value of the Trump Tower penthouse or any of that. I didn't give them square footage. Nope, none of that happened. And as Weisselberg was giving his testimony, Forbes put out an article with emails from Weisselberg from back in the day that said he actually did tell us these things. Like, here's the emails that he sent us. He gave us this information. So at that point, Weisselberg's testimony when this story broke was cut off. They're like, nope, you're done. So that is likely where it came from. He said he wasn't involved. Forbes said, we've got the receipts. So that's where the potential perjury comes from. Engoron this week told both sides, he said, listen, I need explanation. New York Times just ran a report saying that Weisselberg's now in talks for a plea deal over this perjury. Did he lie in my courtroom? Because if he did, I got to throw out his whole testimony. And of course, that's devastating for Donald Trump because Weisselberg downplayed Trump's involvement and basically made it seem like Trump had no idea what was taking place. If that whole testimony is thrown out, Trump is screwed. So Trump's lawyers Wednesday evening responded. And the response is basically, screw the New York Times, right? Don't believe everything that you read, Judge. Here's what his two idiot lawyers had to say. This is from Clifford Robert. Clifford Robert responded in the response to the judge. He said, quote, the article simply does not provide any principled basis for the court to reopen the record or question the veracity of Mr. Weisselberg's testimony in the case. Indeed, we respectfully submit that the court's request for comment on this speculative media account is unprecedented, inappropriate, and troubling. Alina Haba had this to say in her response to the court. She said, the New York Times article is neither admissible nor reliable, and it should not be considered in your Honor's determination as to the merits of this case. Basically, they're saying, Judge, you're overreacting. They're telling the judge, who has sole discretion over the punishment that Donald Trump's about to be handed down, they're like, dude, calm down. Like, why don't you chill out, Judge? Don't believe everything that you read in the Times. Here's the thing, though. The judge wasn't looking to say, hey, the New York Times says this, so I'm going to do this. He said, can somebody explain this to me? That's all he wanted, an explanation. He wanted information. He didn't say, oh, the New York Times says I'm going to screw you over. He was like, hey, could somebody, for the love of God, explain this? And Trump's lawyers were like, screw it. You shouldn't even be reading it. So just when you think Trump's lawyers, including Alina Habba, couldn't get any worse, they probably just destroyed any chance they had of not having Donald Trump lose everything that he has built throughout his entire life. Engoron will have no choice at this point, based on their responses, to completely throw out Weisselberg's testimony, which of course is going to result in the harshest penalty possible for Donald Trump. And a good reason for that, a good portion of the responsibility, is because his lawyers are some of the worst I have ever seen. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.